Okay, let's continue with the topic. So the lymphatic system and immune system. So the immune system, we call it as the body's defense mechanism. Means the body will be fighting against the infections such as bacteria, virus, protozoa, fungi, all these infections, the fighting capacity of the body, we call it as immunity. And the system works under this, we call it as immune system. Under immune system, the lymphatic system also will play a key role. So coming to the functions of the lymphatic system, first we have to know what is the lymphatic system. So I'll just explain you what is lymphatic system. So initially, our heart will pump the blood to all over the body parts. Okay, so our heart will pump the oxygenated blood to each and every cell. It will reach each and every cell of the body. Already we have been seen in the topic of blood. In the blood, we have the cellular part as well as fluid part. So we call the fluid part as plasma. Okay, so when the blood enters into this tissues, not the cellular part is entering. So the cellular part cannot enter into the tissues. Only the liquid part, the plasma alone, will enter into this fluid, so enter into these tissues. So the remaining cells will go through this venous drainage. So when the blood comes to here, so during that period, the plasma only will enter the tissues. Remaining cellular part will go through this venous flow. So later, this fluid has to be drained by some other separate system. So this fluid alone will be drained by a separate system. We call it as lymphatic system. So this lymphatic system alone will drain the plasma from these tissues and again bring back to the venous drainage. So like how the separated blood, so here the blood will get separated into cellular part and fluid part. Cellular part will go into the venous drainage and fluid part will come into the tissues. That fluid alone will be drained by a separate system, which we call it as lymphatic system. So why we call it as a lymphatic system is, if the fluid present in the blood, we call it as plasma. If the fluid present in the tissues, we call it as tissue fluid. If the fluid present in this lymphatic system, we call that as lymph. So the fluid alone, we call it as lymph because it carries the lymph. So that's why we call that system as lymphatic system. So and how it works as an immune system is, so when the lymphatic system is carrying the lymph, it may contain the bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa, any other harmful chemicals. So those things will be detected in between by lymph nodes. Lymph nodes are nothing but the regions in which it consists of lymphocytes. So in the lymphocytes will kill the bacteria, virus. They are called it as phagocytosis. So that process means eating of the bacteria, virus. So that will be happening in the lymph nodes. That lymph nodes are located in between the lymphatic vessels. So where and all you have the lymphocytes, that we call it as lymphatic tissue or lymphoid. So this was the main aim of the lymphatic system. So let's see the anatomy part. Coming to the functions, lymphatic vessels are a network of blood vessels. So that will pick up the excessive tissue fluid. After picking up the excessive tissue fluid, it will clean it. How it will clean it is, in between the lymphatic vessels, it has lymphatic nodes. In the lymphatic nodes, it has lymphocytes. So that will act as a checkpoints. So the checkpoints will identify the bacteria, fungi or protozoa, and that will kill it in the form of a process called phagocytosis. And it will return the cleaned fluid through the circulatory system back. So and we have the lymphatic vessels in the digestive system also. That will actually will pick up the fat absorbed by the digestive system. Coming to the functions of immune system, that will fight the diseases and infections. So coming to the organs of lymphatic system, in what and all the organs, we have the lymphocytes and the macrophages, so phagocytic cells, that we call it as lymphoid tissues. So the lymphoid tissues are lymph nodes, lymphatic vessels, thymus gland, spleen, tonsils. So these are all will comes under the lymphatic system, which consists of lymphocytes. And in this picture, you can see in the entire body, we have the network of lymphatic vessels. In between the lymphatic vessels, we have this lymph nodes. We also call it as lymph gland or lymph node, both are same. So in this, it contains the lymphocytes. And again, this is thymus gland. So this thymus is responsible for the body's defense mechanism because it produces the hormone called thymosin. So the thymosin is for activating the T lymphocytes. And this is tonsils. Tonsils are the lymphoid tissue located in the throat. So when we are eating the food, drinking water or any other fluids, so it will clear or clean that thing before eating and drinking. And this is spleen. So this we also call it as graveyard of RBC. This is also a lymphoid tissue. And this is the lymphatic vessel which carries the lymph. The specialty of the lymphatic vessel is it has the valve. Or if it has the valve means it always process the one-way direction of the lymph. There is no, again, regurgitation will not be possible. Regurgitation means backward flow of the fluid. So coming to the combining forms, what we use in the lymphatic system is adenoids. So adenoido, which means adenoids. So adenoids are nothing but, these are also a type of tonsils present nearby the nasopharynx. So the tonsils present nearby the nasopharynx, we call it as adenoids. So for most of the people, you will be heard that inflammation of this adenoids, it leads to a condition called adenoiditis. In that case, they will remove the adenoids with surgery. Immuno, the meaning of immuno is protection. Lympho is lymph. Lymph adeno means lymph node. Adeno means enlarged gland. That's it. And lymph angio, lymph vessel. Patho is disease. So pathology, study of disease. Spleeno is spleen. So just remain, spleen is the graveyard of RBC. The RBC will finally die in the spleen. Thymo, which is thymus. Tonsillo are the lymphoid organ that is present in the neck region. So usually the tonsils also will get inflammation. We call it as tonsillitis. So that if tonsillitis was recurrent, means occurring again and again, so they will remove the tonsils. We call it as tonsillectomy, which is very common. Nowadays, most of the people are not going for tonsillectomy. Usually they are curing with corticosteroid injections. And toxo means poison. And coming to the suffixes, globulin means protein. So immunoglobulins, proteins which fight against the infections. Coming to the anatomy and physiology again, lymphatic vessels, lymph nodes, spleen, thymus, tonsils. So each function is different from another. First one, so it will remove, the lymphatic system will remove the excess of tissue fluid, which it will be collected throughout the body and finally return it to the circulatory system. Lymph is nothing but the fluid present in the lymphatic system. So we call that as lymph. So in this picture, again, you can see initially the heart will pump the blood. Just see the arrow. Initially, the heart will pump the blood. So the heart will pump the oxygenated blood. Along with oxygen, it also carries the remaining enzymes, hormones, nutrients, and many things it will carry. So it will carry to this each and every tissues. Only the plasma will get leak into the tissues. So when the plasma will leak into the tissues, then we call that as tissue fluid. And again, the cellular part, RBC, WBC, platelets, plasma proteins, that will return into these veins. And the tissue fluid alone will be drained by this lymphatic system. Finally, the plasma and the cells again combine here and it will back to the heart. So, second, lymphatic vessels are all around the body. So, nearby the intestine also we have the lymphatic vessels, which helps for fat absorption. It will pick up the unabsorbed fat and delivers to the circulatory system. So, the lymphatic vessels in the digestive system, we call it as lacteals, because that will collect the fat. And thirdly, the lymphatic and immune network works together. So there was a group of cells, tissues, organs, and molecules. These are nothing but a primary defense against the pathogens. Pathogens means disease causing agents. So this is the lymphatic vessel. You can see in this picture. So these are valves. Valves are usually helps to flow the lymph in unidirectional fashion. So only in one direction the lymph will flow, and the pressure recorded inside the lymphatic vessels are very low, and it doesn't promote the backward flow of the fluid. And this was the real picture of the lymphatic vessel, and this is the valve, lymphatic valve. And the lymphatic vessels are nothing but a very small vessels. This very small, we call it as lymph capillaries. So all the lymph small capillaries will merge to form lymphatic vessel, and finally will drain into a larger tube, which we call it as lymphatic ducts. So finally that will end in the thoracic cavity. So in finally that will drain into the inferior vena cava. And here you can see that nodes. So if the nodes are present nearby the neck region, then we call it as cervical nodes. If the nodes are present nearby the chest region, nearby the heart, then we call it as mediastinal nodes. If the nodes are present nearby the armpit, then we call it as axillary nodes. If the nodes are present nearby the groin region, then it is inguinal nodes. So what is a lymphatic node? So this was the lymphatic node, or lymphatic lymph gland we call it as. So this is not a real gland. It is composed of lymphatic tissue. So located in between the lymphatic vessels. So assume the lymph is coming from here. Here it was a checkpoint. It will check the fluid whether it is having any pathogens or not. And after checking, it will leave the lymphatic fluid by this way. And you can see here in this picture very clearly. So the lymph will be coming in this direction, entering in this direction. So inside this, the lymphocytes and antibodies will be there that will be checking for any pathogens. And after checking it and cleaning it, and the lymph will go by this direction. So lymphatic node are housed for the lymphocytes and antibodies. So it will remove the pathogens and cell debris from the lymph, and it passes through. And it also has the capacity to trap and destroy the cancerous cells also. So coming to the sites of lymphatic nodes, where most of the lymphatic nodes are concentrated, axillary means armpit, cervical, which is neck region, inguinal, which is groin, mediastinal, chest region. And tonsils. Tonsils are the lymphatic tissue located nearby the throat, means nearby the pharyngeal region. We have three sets of tonsils. If the tonsils are present nearby the palate, then we call it as palatine tonsils. If the tonsils are present nearby the pharyngeal region, we call it as pharyngeal tonsils. If the tonsils are present above the neck region, above the tongue region, then we call it as lingual tonsils. You can see in this picture, So what is the function of tonsils is, it has white blood cells inside it, and that also will act as a filtering the pathogens when what and all the contents that is entering into the digestive system and respiratory system. Means it will clear the air and it will clear the food and liquids. So spleen. So this is the spleen, which is being located in the left side of the abdomen. It also contains the lymphatic tissue, and it highly will filtrate the blood vessels. And spleen also contains the phagocytic macrophages. Macrophages are nothing but white blood cells only. So when the blood is moving slowly into the spleen, it will identify the pathogens and it will kill it. And also it will destroy the RBC. So once the lifetime of RBC was completed, that will be also destroyed. And it will filter the old RBC and it will recycle the iron. And the remaining bilirubin will send to the liver for processing. And it is not an essential organ, spleen. If the spleen is not there in our body also, we can survive. And thymus gland, which is present nearby the front of the heart, we call it as mediastinal region, that will secrete a hormone called thymosin. So thymosin is responsible for activating the T lymphocytes, and it was very active in unborn child and throughout the childhood and adolescence age. So when the adolescence, 12 to 18 years, that we call it as adolescence period. So by that period, the thymus gland will shrink its size. So by this time, we don't have a thymus gland. So essentially, it is very important for the proper development of T lymphocytes. So which is responsible for cell mediated immunity, means immunity in the tissues. And immunity. So what is an immunity? So what is an immunity means our body's capacity to fight against the pathogens, we call it as immunity. We also call it as defense mechanism of our body. It can identify and kill the bacteria, virus, fungi, protozoa, toxins that is released by all these pathogens, and also the cancerous cells also. It has a capacity to identify all these things and kill it. So the killing process, we call it as phagocytosis. And we have two types of immunity. One is natural immunity and other one is acquired immunity. Natural immunity is that is present in our body itself from the birth. So from the birth itself, we have that immunity. So that we call it as innate immunity. Innate means from the birth. Nate means birth. So innate, from the birth itself, we have this immunity. So it is not specific to particular disease. Like for example, it will only fight with the polio. It will only fight with the measles. Not like that. It will fight to all the bacteria, all the virus. So there is no disease specific and all. When it was exposed, when we doesn't expose it prior to the pathogens, even though we have this immunity. So examples are all the WBC cells, neutrophils, eosinophils, basophils, lymphocytes, monocytes, macrophages, all these will come under innate immunity because this immunity will be present from birth itself. And acquired immunity. Acquired immunity, we acquired after birth, then we call it as acquired immunity. That is of two types. One is actively acquired immunity. Other one is passively acquired immunity. So the difference between actively acquired immunity and passively acquired immunity is, so for example, if when we are children, we usually will get smallpox or chickenpox. That is very common. So only once in our lifetime, we get that disease. When we initially attacked with the smallpox, so what happened is, the antibodies will be developed to that smallpox. Initially, we will suffer because our body will be preparing the antibodies during that incubation period. We will get fever, rashes, all those things. After the second infection, if again we got infected with the smallpox, our body was already had a memory how to fight with the smallpox. So if we infected recurrent times also, we will not suffer. So we was immunized with the first attack. That we call it as actively acquired immunity. So our body itself developed the antibodies and learned how to fight with that pathogen. So that was actively acquired immunity. Usually for the actively acquired immunity, so we usually go for immunization and vaccinations. So in this process, we are injecting the dead or live virus. For example, if it is a polio virus, in two ways the polio virus will be injected. One is live attenuated and other one is dead virus. Live attenuated virus is given through polio drops and dead virus is given with the polio injection. So in the two ways, the virus will be entering into the body. After the virus entering into the body, our body will start preparing antibodies, which is pathogen specific. That antibodies will act against only on the polio. So that's why we differentiated innate immunity is not pathogen specific, but acquired immunity was pathogen specific. So likewise, our body will be prepared antibiotics in actively acquired immunity. But in passively acquired immunity, for example, when the baby was born, so usually the mother milk is the best thing in the world. So mother milk cannot be replaced with anything because in the mother milk will be having IgA antibodies, immunoglobulin A antibodies that can only be given by the mother, which can be taken by the baby. So that is only possible with the mother and child. So that's how the mother milk is very, very important to the baby. So So the baby cannot prepare that antibodies. So passively from the mother to the baby, the readily prepared antibodies was been going, which we call it as passively acquired immunity. And one more very important example is, in the recent times, when a person was affected with COVID and he was recovered from the COVID, but in his blood, he has COVID antibodies. For example, the other person, assume the person B, he got infected with COVID and he's been suffering. So for that person, so who is already recovered from COVID, so in this person plasma can be given to the person B. So like how the readily prepared antibodies was been injecting to the other person who is been suffering from COVID. So which is a process called plasmapheresis, means removal of plasma from a person and transfuse to other person. So this is also a type of passively acquired immunity. The main difference between actively acquired and passively acquired is, in the actively acquired immunity, the body itself will prepare the antibodies. In the passively acquired immunity, the readily prepared antibodies will be injected to the person. So immunity is of two different types. One is humoral immunity, means the immunity is present in the blood. We also call it as antibody mediated immunity. And we have cellular immunity. The immunity in the tissue level, we call it as cellular immunity. B lymphocytes are responsible for humoral immunity. And T lymphocytes are responsible for cell mediated immunity. So humoral immunity, which involves the B lymphocytes are responsible. B means bone marrow activated lymphocytes. So that will produce a protective protein, which we call it as antibodies. So the antigen will fight against the antibody and will form an antigen-antibody complex. So now what happens is that targets the pathogen for phagocytosis, means eating of the bacteria, virus or whatnot, and prevents the infection causing from, and also it will prevent from damaging the healthy cells. And cellular immunity. So T cells are the natural killer cells that is mainly responsible for cellular mediated immunity, which helps for preventing, which is cytotoxic in nature and physically attacks and destroys the pathogenic cells. And the standard precautions we have to take to keep safe our immunity is, one is we have many infections. Here, some of the infections are nosocomial infection. So when we go to the hospital, from the hospital, if we get any infections, so usually if many people, they'll get cold, they'll get fever when they go to the hospitals. These type of infections, we call it as hospital acquired infections. And for example, if we went to the pulmonology ward, there are many TB patients. When they are not isolated, we may get a chance of getting infection. That's why when you are entering into the hospital, we have to be very safe. Even we have to put a mask and we always have to be sanitized after coming out from the hospital. And cross-infection. So from one person to other person, like how the COVID will spread. So that is a cross-infection. Reinfection. Once the person got infected and again if he is infecting, then we call it as reinfection. And next, self-inoculation. So for the person when he got TB to the lungs and again he is getting TB to the spine, then we call this as self-inoculation. So one part of the body got infected. Again, the other part of the body is getting infecting after some time. Then we call it as self-inoculation. Coming to the standard precautions. So we have to wash the hands thoroughly and we have to put the gloves. So what and all we are doing during this pandemic period. So all the safety precautions has been given here. And we have to wear a non-permeable gown or apron. So to prevent against that mucus-related infections. And all this, we have to always put a face mask, glasses. Even through eyes also, we get an infection. And we also have to properly dispose the mask and remaining sanitary pads. Okay, let's see the word-building part. Adenoidectomy, surgical removal of adenoids. Adenoiditis. Itis means inflammation. So inflammation of the adenoids. Immunologist, the immunity specialist. Lymphadenectomy, surgical removal of lymph gland. Lymphadenopathy, lymph gland disease. Lymph angiogram. Angiogram means record of vessel. So lymph angiogram is record of lymph vessel. Lymph angioma, lymph vessel tumor. Lymphoma, lymphatic tumor. Lymphatic pertaining to the lymph. Pathogenic, disease producing. Pathology, study of disease. Splenectomy, surgical removal of spleen. Splenomegaly, enlarged spleen. And thymectomy, surgical removal of thymus. Thymoma, thymus tumor. Tonsillar, pertaining to tonsils. Tonsillectomy, surgical removal of tonsils. And tonsillitis, inflammation of tonsils. So let's see the immune system vocabulary part. Allergen. So allergen are the substances which causes the allergy reaction. We call it as allergen. Allergist, the person who is specialized in testing and treating the allergies. Allergy, any hypersensitive reaction to any common substance, we call it as allergy. And autoimmune disease, so this was the disease. Our own antigens will fight with our own antibodies. We also call it as autoimmune disease. Examples are rheumatoid arthritis and systemic lupus erythematosus. And hives, for example, if the person is having any allergy, after severe itching, so itching we call it as urticaria. Urticaria means severe itching. So after severe itching, they will get a reddish spots all over the body. So that reddish inflamed spots, we call it as VLs. So appearance of VLs because of allergic reaction. HIV, human immunodeficiency virus. So this virus will lead to AIDS. So usually when the person got infected with HIV, he will come to know that he got AIDS after 5 to 10 years only. So the incubation period for AIDS is, HIV is 5 to 10 years. And immunocompromised. So nowadays in the pandemic time, who and all was immunocompromised, means who and all have weakened immunity. So they'll get the COVID-19 or any other diseases very easily. And immunoglobulins, these are the proteins. So we also call it as antibodies, which fights against antigens. Antigens means bacteria, virus, all those things we call it as antigens. And immunology, which is a branch of medicine, particularly treating about immune system disorders. Inflammation, so when the body's response against injury, we call it as inflammation, the body will become red, pain, swelling, and feeling hot to touch. The body under flame means inflame. Lymphedema. Edema means the excessive tissue fluid was being blocked in the tissues itself. That was not drained by the lymphatic system. You can see the edematous limb means the leg or hand will become very big. So that will be for a long period of time. That we call it as lymphedema. You may also be noticed elephantiasis. The leg will become very big like an elephant leg. So, which is a viral infection, so caused by Wuchereria brancofti, that virus name is. That condition we call it as lymphedema. Opportunistic infection. So the infection will be easily caused to a person called immunocompromised person. Urticaria, severe itching, we call it as urticaria, which is very common for allergic person. So this we call it as cellulitis. So, which is an allergy reaction. So, the body will get inflamed. Red in color, pain, hot to touch. So, these are the signs and symptoms. And coming to the allergic reaction, anaphylactic shock. For certain common substance will attack the respiratory and cardiovascular system. For example, there are certain people who is allergy even to the banana also. So, I have seen a case. So, the person was allergy to banana. And that attacked his respiratory system. He couldn't able to breathe properly. So which any allergic reaction which is life threatening, that we call it as anaphylactic shock. And elephantiasis, which we also call it as lymphedema. So this is due to inflammation and obstruction of lymphatic vessels. And Hodgkin's disease, cancer to the lymphatic cells. So which is concentrated mainly in the lymph nodes. Lymphadenitis, inflammation of lymph nodes. we also call it as swollen glands. And mononucleosis, which is a viral infection which affects the lymphocytes. Non-Hodgkin's lymphoma, this is very, other than Hodgkin's lymphoma, it is cancer to the lymphatic tissue. And AIDS, acquired immunodeficiency syndrome, so which is which affects mainly the cell-mediated immunity, means which mainly attacks the T lymphocytes. So T lymphocytes, and it is caused by the virus called HIV. AIDS-related complex, which is the early stage of AIDS, the symptoms will be weight loss, fatigue, anorexia. Anorexia means loss of appetite. Graft versus host disease. For certain cases, so when the person had a recent kidney transplantation or bone marrow transplantation, the body will not accept the transplant. So the body will recognize that it is not my own product. So that will usually reject it. So nowadays, this complication was reduced by giving anti-antibodies prior to the surgery. Kaposi sarcoma, which is skin cancer in the AIDS patient. And pneumocystis carinii pneumonia. This is also an opportunistic infection, particularly to the AIDS patient. Sarcoidosis, which is an autoimmune disease, which is forming the fibrous lesions in many organs. Severe combined immunodeficiency syndrome, we call it as SIDS, which is a genetic disorder. So usually the baby will be born without functioning immune system. Coming to the clinical laboratory test, ELSA means it was the test for AIDS to confirm whether the person is having AIDS or not. And the Western blot, so which is a backup test for AIDS. If we get the negative ELSA test, so the person can confirm with Western blot test whether he is having AIDS or not. And lymph angiography, X-ray to the lymphatic vessels after injecting a dye. Without injecting the dye, they cannot take an X-ray of lymphatic vessels. Monospot, which is a test for mononucleosis, and a scratch test. For example, if you want to find out if we are allergy to any other products, then how they will test is, they will take a needle and with the needle, they will inject that substance and they will see whether the person is getting any allergy or not, which we call it as scratch test. So like this, they will inject the allergens with the needle. And this is positive scratch test. So the person is having allergy to that particular substance. So that's how he got inflammation. So I'll reconnect the call because it is getting disconnected. Okay.
Okay.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, fine. I'll